हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डिम्पल रंगीला एंड टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट स्टोरी टेलिंग एंड हाउ इट कैन बी यूज फॉर लैंग्वेज डेवलपमेंट इन अ क्लासरूम। सो लेट्स फर्स्ट डिस्कस दैट व्हाई शुड वी यूज स्टोरी टेलिंग इन क्लासरूम। लिसनिंग एंड टेलिंग स्टोरीज हेल्प चिल्ड्रन इन लर्निंग लैंग्वेज इन प्राइमरी क्लासेस। लिसनिंग टू स्टोरीज इज ऑफ इंटरेस्ट टू चिल्ड्रन एंड ऑल्सो इन्हांसेस देयर क्रिएटिविटी। ऑफन इट इज सीन दैट चिल्ड्रन mold the stories they have heard as per their wishes while telling it to their friends. Through this, they not only learn meaning of words but also develop an understanding of various incidents, and this facilitates in enhancing their imagination. They would be talking about their own experiences or stories of what they have heard from others. It enhances the ability of children to estimate. For example, whenever children are listening to a story, they are curious to know what happens next. They guess as per their understanding, and if the story progresses as per their guess, they grow more confident, and with time their estimates become more accurate. Most notably, these stories help the children to prepare for their future life. For example, the rabbit and the lion story prepares them mentally to face the difficulties that life brings in front of them. In storytelling, we keep incorporating our life experiences. Sometimes, when the storyteller finds something very important, then she exaggerates that part of the story and emphasizes the same part. While doing this, main focus is on shaping the life's incidents, characters, etc., and also in attracting the attention of the listener. Moreover, the storyteller's manner of telling the story impacts the interest generated in the story. And whenever new words are used in a story, the children are able to guess the meaning of the word by observing the expressions of the storyteller. This facilitates in enhancing their vocabulary, listening, understanding, and estimation. Discussing about a story after listening to it is a little difficult task, but if the teacher is prepared with its objectives, then it can become a useful medium. Most of the teachers feel that after telling the story, it is their right to ask the children about the lesson they have learned from it. Whereas, in order to initiate a meaningful dialogue with the children, raising the question is not at all correct. Many a times, the children themselves ask questions or raise certain issues that are pertinent to the story in question. Telling stories to children is as important as listening to stories from them. This helps the children in developing their ability to express themselves. In fact, children as storytellers is one such area which needs to be explored a lot. Instead of asking the children to repeat the story told by the teacher, it is more beneficial to ask them to tell any story that they like. While responding to the personality and the character of the story, the child includes her experiences in it. Every child in the class should be given the freedom that she can talk anything regarding the story and can even exaggerate through his or her imagination. Now, how we can use it in a classroom? It is a great tool to form rapport with children, to make connections, to help children to express themselves. It strokes their imagination, makes them curious, and then they predict that what will happen next in the story. It is a great classroom management technique and makes the children much more receptive, apart from all the advantages in the language development. Sensitive issues can also be discussed by using storytelling as a tool in the classroom. Storytelling can generate meaningful discussion and help in forming peer relationships. So, let us see the advantages of storytelling for children. As a cognitive process, it helps children to infer and derive meaning from what they have heard. It helps them further in problem solving because they relate the happenings of the story to their real life situation. It helps them to sequence the story and in exploration. It helps them to understand emotions of their own selves as well as emotions of the others. They also learn to empathize. That means they learn to put themselves in the other person's shoe to understand how another person would be feeling at a particular time. It further enhances social development. As children, when they are together in the classroom, it leads to collaboration, cooperation, initiative taking, and one story can generate multiple views and perspectives of children. Furthermore, it also addresses diversity in the classroom. And it also gives a conversational flow to the child, which means that the child gets his or her own space to express himself, and which leads to active participation and meaningful engagement in the classroom. Advantages for teachers and schools. It helps teachers to reach out to all the students, and further it addresses diversity in the classroom, because in a class there are children who come from diverse backgrounds. Diversity can be based on the basis of caste, class, gender, and even the language that they speak. It equips teachers to sustain children's interests and creates meaningful association with children, and the connect that the teacher will be able to form with the children in the classroom will be a long-lasting and an impactful connect. It helps them understand cultural context of the children in the classroom. They will be able to understand each and every child, and children can be given active voices in their own learning experiences where they themselves are voicing their opinions. So now I am going to suggest a few activities that are related to storytelling that can be used in the classroom. So here you can see that we can explore storytelling through children's drawings. That is, after narrating a story to the children, or if a story is narrated by the children themselves, we can ask them to draw any particular character from the story that they like, or any scene from the story that they would like to draw. We can also ask, along with this, while they are drawing or after the drawing is completed, we can ask them what they have drawn. This will lead to a dialogue that would be generated with the children, and they will become more confident about speaking about what they have drawn. So here, as you can see in the picture, children have drawn pictures from various stories that they have shared. For example, Goldilocks and the Three Bears, Snow White, The Wonderful Wizard of Oz, The Chocolate Factory. Here we can see that we can also find out certain gender differences in drawings of children based on the stories. So for example, the slide that is the drawing that is on the left side, we can see a man and he is having a gun in his hand and using it with another person. It is drawn by a boy, whereas girls choose to draw another girl and birds the clouds. This is a story which was narrated to children to know, to tell them about the water cycle. So children really like the idea of the rainbow. So all of them chose to draw a rainbow from the particular story. Again, when the water cycle was getting completed, so children drew how the drop, which after evaporation goes up to the sky, it has come back. So they have drawn their interpretation of the water cycle in this case, the story on the water cycle. So children's drawings are the combination of these visuals and the words which we'll ask children to talk about, captures children's attention, concentration and recall, because they will have to talk about what they have drawn. The illustrations, as you saw in the previous slides, are not just simple visual responses of recall, because the children would have thought about the whole story and then drew certain features from the stories. So it was also at the cognitive level, and it also helped them in the language development. Each drawing further reveals one or the other elements of the story that was shared by the child himself or herself. Children also extend their verbal expression through the drawings, which is also shared by a cognitive development theory by Vygotsky. Then we can also narrate children incomplete stories and ask them to complete these stories. So story completion is the next activity. So children listen, visualize, reflect, and then suggest alternatives and express their feelings for the characters of the story in words. For example, if we narrate a story to the children and do not complete it, and we ask them to complete the whole story. So every child can give a different version of the story. In this, they may extend the story, distort it, substitute new characters, and maybe at times they can add new characters and make up their own stories. Furthermore, it gives personal interpretation and meaning to the story, wherein every child will give or might give a different meaning. It leads to comprehension of the story at different levels, because all the children will be understanding the story at their own levels, and the way they will relate to the story or the characters of the story will also be different from other children. It will lead to free expression and response from all the children. So this is one method that can make the whole class inclusive, as all children can be participating in one or the other activity. Then we can also use role play or story enactment, wherein after sharing a few stories with the children, we can ask them to enact the story. We can form groups of children, and then we can give them different stories on which they would be enacting. It has been found that when children enact and do dramatization of these stories, it gives them a freedom to infer, derive meaning, and modify the story at their own discretion, because they will think of the characters, who will become what character, who will be the narrator of the story, how are they going to portray the different characters of the story. So all this, they will also be together and work on it. It also helps them in problem solving, as they deal with the challenge and bring about a resolution. And since it will be a group activity, a lot of group dynamics can also be understood. Innovation and spontaneity are also evident through their thoughts and actions. Many a times, immediately the children have to improvise on the role that they are having in the story. So that innovation and spontaneity becomes very important in storytelling. The flexible nature of these enactments make the classroom again very inclusive, wherein all the children can be participating in these activities and can have different roles in the story enactment process. Stories by children. So now we will talk about children as storytellers, wherein they themselves make their own stories and share their stories. So till now we spoke about children as listeners. Now when we give an opportunity to children to tell their own stories, it transforms them from listeners to active participants in the storytelling process. The opportunity gives them a conversational floor, as I talked about earlier also, to get their voices heard, and they really look forward to this personal space wherein they can share their stories with others. This not only makes them feel confident, but also increases their self-esteem and self-worth, and they take pride in sharing these stories with others, and they also like the idea that they are being heard by others. The activity leads to free expression of ideas, and individual voices receive equal attention from all. So, till now we talked about the group storytelling activity. This is being an individual activity. Children will get an individual expression of their thoughts, and that expression will come in through their stories. And believe me, it is something which will be attended by all, because stories take the children away from the immediate surrounding of the classroom to the space where they are talking about in a particular stories. This way, stories also turn to become a traveling metaphor. By traveling metaphor, I mean that stories travel across space from one place to the other. When the children will be sharing these stories with their other peers, or maybe their siblings, they go back and share with their parents, grandparents, uncles or aunts. This way, no story will remain an untold story. All the stories this way will travel from one place to the other and will be shared by one person or the other person. And then, every time a story travels, it will be transformed by that person's interpretation. So that will give a new meaning to the story. Children also voice what an ideal story should be like. Now, since we are talking about active agency of children, so they also have a voice in what an ideal story should be like. So children usually like stories which have animal characters, And stories which start, which have a particular clear beginning, there is a middle in which there is a problem posed, and how that challenge is overcome by the central character of the story towards the end. So they like to listen to these stories. To conclude, I would say that storytelling is a social experience in the classroom because it leads to collaboration in across peers in the classroom. They all come together and the group dynamics in the classroom become very important if we give them activities to be done in groups. Such a classroom environments provide children opportunities to try out new social roles, because during, as I said, enactment of a story, they will take up new roles. So they will know how a particular person has his or her own role, and they would like to be in that role. And also they will use the language constructively. They will form their own characters. They will give dialogues to their characters. There will be dialogue delivery. And they will also see at the same time how their dialogues are making an impact on the audience. Many a times they also change the dialogues according to the audience. If they think that the audience is not liking it, they may add humor to the story. So it's all adds to their own constructive experiences, and along with that, creativity in the classroom. Children further, they become active meaning makers and contributors. This way they become producers of knowledge and not just as consumers of knowledge in the classroom, because we are giving them an active agency through which they engage meaningfully within the classroom, individually or in group with the other children. Thus, we can say that storytelling promotes initiative taking in children. It leads to a lot of imagination. Children bring innovation through different storytelling activities. Is interesting for them, and since it's an interactive activity, it further leads to enhancement of language development. It allows for cognitive exploration. They explore the various viewpoints, the multiple perspectives that other children are giving, leads to experimentation and experience. And the kind of experience that they gain from storytelling as an activity works multifold. It helps in holistic development of children. Thus, in today's session on storytelling and how it leads to language development in the classroom, we learnt about the use of storytelling and furthermore the advantages of storytelling, and in a classroom how using different activities we can make storytelling as a tool to enhance the language development of the child, and furthermore which leads to the holistic development of the child. Thank you.
पच्चीस साल का लंबा सफर और लाखों लोगों के चेहरों पर खिलती मुस्कान, गर्व और गरिमा से जीने की प्रेरणा देती मुस्कान, आत्मसम्मान और विश्वास से पैदा हुई मुस्कान, इन खिलते चेहरों पर ये मुस्कान आई है शिक्षा के जरिए। ये मुस्कान आई है नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ओपन स्कूलिंग यानी NIOS के जरिए। नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ओपन स्कूलिंग या राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालयी शिक्षा संस्थान, इस संस्थान का एक बड़ा उद्देश्य है आम आदमियों के जीवन को बेहतर बनाना। ऐसे लोग जिनके लिए शिक्षा एक दूर का सपना है, या वे बच्चे जो परिवार की रोजी रोटी कमाने के लिए बीच में ही स्कूल छोड़ने पर मजबूर हो जाते हैं। NIOS ऐसे बच्चों और बड़ों को दोबारा शिक्षा से जुड़ने का मौका मुहैया कराता है, ताकि वे एक बेहतर जीवन जी सकें। 1989 में स्थापना के बाद NIOS ने देश के लाखों बच्चों और वयस्कों को बेहतर शिक्षा से जोड़ा है। इनमें हर उम्र, हर पृष्ठभूमि, हर जाति, हर मजहब और हर क्षेत्र के लड़के लड़कियां, महिलाएं और पुरुष शामिल हैं। बड़ई से लेकर पायलट, डॉक्टर, इंजीनियर, बेकर और दर्जी तक, NIOS कोशिश कर रहा है सबको शिक्षित और सशक्त बनाने की, चाहे वो असम के दूर दराज इलाके में रहने वाला हो या फिर मुंबई जैसे महानगर का। NIOS ने अपनी मौजूदगी हर जगह दर्ज कराई है। NIOS ने शिक्षा की परंपरागत सोच को ही बदल दिया है। वो पढ़िए जो हम पढ़ाते हैं की जगह NIOS की नई सोच है। हम वो पढ़ाते हैं जो आप पढ़ना चाहते हैं। इस नई सोच ने लोगों को आगे बढ़ने और NIOS के साथ जुड़ने के लिए प्रोत्साहित किया है। शिक्षा उपलब्ध कराने के मामले में NIOS किसी सीमा को नहीं मानता, उम्र की सीमा को भी नहीं। चंडीगढ़ के गणेश के लिए भी NIOS एक वरदान साबित हुआ। NIOS शारीरिक रूप से अक्षम बच्चों को भी बेहतर शिक्षा मुहैया कराने के लिए पूरी तरह प्रतिबद्ध है। ऐसे बच्चों के लिए शिक्षा न केवल रोजगार के द्वार खोलती है, बल्कि उन्हें आत्मविश्वास और गर्व के साथ जीना भी सिखाती है। NIOS खेल के इन सितारों को उनकी सुविधा और समय के अनुसार बेहतर शिक्षा उपलब्ध कराता है। मेरी कॉम, सोमदेव देववर्मन, देविका रिबेका पल्लिकल, अरमान इब्राहिम, प्रद्युमन प्रकाश और अमय ज्योत सिंह, NIOS सीमा पर खड़े उन प्रहरियों को भी शिक्षा से लाभान्वित करता है जो देश की सुरक्षा के लिए अपनी जान की बाजी लगाने से भी नहीं चूकते। सच तो ये है कि NIOS की पहुंच हर ओर रहती है, चाहे वो दूर दराज के आदिवासी हो या जेल की कोठरी में बंद कैदी या फिर ग्रामीण और शहरी क्षेत्रों के गरीब निवासी। देश में कहीं भी कोई भी व्यक्ति, स्त्री, पुरुष, लड़का, लड़की, अमीर, गरीब, शिक्षा से वंचित न रहे। राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान का यही मिशन है।
राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान पूरे देश में शिक्षा के साथ साथ कौशल विकास के क्षेत्र में बहुत सारे कोर्सेज दे रहा है। लगभग 100 से ज़्यादा कोर्सेज हैं। हम दूर दराज के गांव में अपने संस्थान बनाते हैं और वहां के बच्चों को, वहां के बच्चियों को, वहां के वयस्कों को हुनर के क्षेत्र में शिक्षा पहुंचाते हैं। आपको जानकर खुशी होगी कि अब हम आर्ट, साइंस, कॉमर्स जिन क्षेत्रों में 12वीं का सर्टिफिकेट दिया जाता रहा है, अब हम हुनर के क्षेत्र में, वोकेशनल एरिया में भी 10वीं और 12वीं का सर्टिफिकेशन करेंगे। तो वो बच्चे जो कृषि से जुड़े हुए हैं, कारपेंट्री से जुड़े हुए हैं या दूसरे क्षेत्रों से जुड़े हुए हैं, वो अपने ही क्षेत्र में काम करेंगे, सीखेंगे, हुनर पैदा करेंगे अपने में और सर्टिफाइड भी होंगे कि वो सर्टिफाइड कृषक हैं, खेतिहर हैं। तो आज तक जो हमारे देश में ये सोच रही है कि आप 12वीं पास तभी कहे जाएंगे जब भूगोल, अर्थशास्त्र, भौतिकी ये पढ़ेंगे, अब ये समय बदल गया है। ITI में जितने बच्चे पढ़ते हैं, लगभग 18 लाख बच्चे हर साल दाखिला लेते हैं, अब हम उनको सर्टिफिकेशन करेंगे।
NIOS अपने छात्रों को माध्यमिक स्तर पर 26 और उच्च माध्यमिक स्तर पर 19 विषयों का विकल्प देता है। पढ़ाई किस माध्यम से करनी है, इसमें भी आपको लचीलापन मिलेगा। माध्यमिक स्तर पर ही 7 भाषाओं के अलग अलग माध्यमों का विकल्प मौजूद है। शैक्षणिक कार्यक्रमों के अलावा 86 वोकेशनल शिक्षा कार्यक्रम भी उपलब्ध हैं, जो छात्रों को कामकाजी दुनिया के लिए तैयार करते हैं। वोकेशनल प्रशिक्षण को अधिक सुदृढ़ बनाने के लिए NIOS ने ITDC, सिस्को, इंडियन मेडिकल एसोसिएशन जैसे कई सरकारी और गैर सरकारी संस्थानों के साथ भागीदारी स्थापित की है। आज लाखों छात्रों के लिए अपनी पसंद का स्कूल है राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालयी शिक्षा संस्थान, यानी नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ओपन स्कूलिंग। NIOS ने एक लंबा सफर तय किया है, लेकिन मंजिल अभी दूर है। निरंतर विकास और नवीनीकरण के लिए NIOS सदैव प्रतिबद्ध है। शिक्षा का उद्देश्य महज रोजगार जुटाना ही नहीं है, बल्कि स्वयं को सशक्त बनाना भी है। NIOS लाखों छात्रों के लिए यही आत्मसम्मान दिलाने में जुटा है। लाखों लोगों के लिए एक आशा और उम्मीद है। नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ओपन स्कूलिंग। शिक्षा सबके लिए, कहीं भी, कभी भी।
प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने
हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने राहों को करने कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से युक्त हो
कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से युक्त हो
मित्रों हम उठे और जागे
मंजिल आने की ध्वनि सुने हम अपना जीवन स्वयं बने हम अपना
जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने परीक्षा का अवसर एक बार ही क्यों